Thanks for providing hyperlinks. Use anchor tag. Okay. And in anchor tag, there is a one compulsory attribute that is called href. This is called hypertext reference. Clear? So syntax of your anchor tag is a href equal to, then give name of the web page with web page with extension, and if your web page with which you want to provide hyperlink is in this different folder, use the complete address, complete place or location of that file. So hyperlink we can provide on any image, okay, or on any particular table. So on any object we can provide hyperlinks. And second one is, we can provide the hyperlink with any type of file, maybe any your web page, maybe any image file or a video file, audio file. So here is a one web page I have created. Sui.html. So here I have provided hyperlinks with one single web page. I click here to assess web page. So this is my web page. I provided one hyperlink with the website, school website. And third one is, I provide hyperlink on any image and with a file. Okay. And last one is, I provide one hyperlink with video file. Video file will not display everything on the screen, but it will be downloaded. Clear? So it will be downloaded. Now, the coding of this file is, here, my web page is one.html. So I will provide hyperlinks like a href equal to one.html within double quotes. Then the word is click here to assess web page and close the anchor tag. So this is with a simple web page. It is a external hyperlink. Second one. When I want to provide hyperlink with any website, use complete URL. So I am using here HTTP, second one separate, second hyperlink is with the school website. So here is http://, you will use www.swamisandas.com and then click here to assess website. And then I close anchor tag. So this is with the web page. First one is with any web page. Third one, if I want to provide hyperlink with any image, so in href use image name or image complete address in case folders are different. Then I want to place the hyperlink on image. So in place of text, I am using img tag. So img source height and width, I inserted one image, then I close the anchor tag. And in case you want to provide hyperlink with any video, then href, I give here the complete address because my folder of my web page and folder of videos are different. So that's why complete address. I'm not using relative address. Clear? Complete address. And then the word is click here to assess video, and then I close the enter. So this is external hyperlinks. Madhav, clear? So next one is internal hyperlinks. So internal hyperlinks provides the linking with any section of same web page. Okay. In last lecture, one minute better. Okay, student. In this web page, I inserted three images. So the my web page is a very long web page. So if I want to go to the end of the page, here is a one link. Go to the end of the page. I click here, and there is a fast scrolling. The last image is in front of me. Clear? And this is called internal hyperlinks. And internal hyperlinks are useful when your web page is large and you want to make quick scrolling. Okay? So then your internal hyperlinks are important. So I'm going to open the coding of this page. So here, my first, I'm using ahref.table.html. This is my internal link, external hyperlink. Then I give the title. Title is an attribute to give the tooltip. When I place my mouse on the image, on that particular hyperlink, there will be a tooltip. If I open the web page in Chrome and place my mouse on click here. So there is a tooltip. Click here to open tables. Okay. Now in my, after that, I provide another hyperlink, but I am using here ahref equal to hash new. So this is not a image name. Here is note. Not a address of any web page. So I am using hash. Hash indicate it is an internal link. Okay. So you will have to use hash, then use any name. So this is the name of the section. And in your web page, in the end of your web page, I am using a and a, then name is equal to new. Here I am using anchor tag, empty anchor tag. Basically, it is a container, empty tag, the anchor tag is a container tag, but for defining the name, you can take it as a empty tag. So I am taking here a name equal to new. So this at the bottom place name is new. When I click on the go to end of the web page, my link will automatically provide this fast scrolling. And my control will be placed at the end of your web page. Okay. So now if I refresh this web page, so here is go to the end of the page. If I click on click here, I go to the another web page. If I click on go to the end of the page, there will be fast scrolling and you will, your control will be shifted to the last image of your web page. So any doubt in this?
No, sir.
Okay. So next type of hyperlink is mixed link. Okay, mixed hyperlink. That is a mixture of internal and external hyperlinks. So I am going to create that. So here is, I start the web page. So digital I am taking here, ping, then I close body tag and then HTML tag. This is a complete structure of your my web page. So here I want to provide, click here to assess last image. So my web page main.html, it contains three pictures. And I want to provide hyperlinks with this web page, but on clicking on, click here to assess last web page, my control shifted to the last image, okay? So I know that in my this page main.html, I use the one tag a name equal to new. So मेरे पास एक उस web page के bottom का मैंने section को name दिया हुआ है name equal to new. तो यहाँ पे मैं web page में hyperlinks provide करूँगा a href equal to in double quotes. My file name is main.html. ठीक है, तो मैंने यहाँ पे एज इट इज लगा दिया, इट इज एक्सटर्नल लिंक. आई सेव दिस वेब पेज, नेम ऑफ दिस वेब पेज इज 4.html. आई सेव दिस फाइल. And in a 4.html, here is my link is here. I click here. My next web page is appear in the screen, but it is from the beginning. Clear? So if I want to use the hyperlink and I want to open the I want to shift my control in the end of next web page main.html, then it is called mixed link. In one side we are using another file that is main.html, and we want to provide hyperlink with the one section, then use here hash new. New is the name of the section, main.html hash new. I save this web page. I refresh the web page. Click here to assess last image. Okay. I am going to click here. ये देखो बेटा. Web page में last image display हो गई. Yes. Automatically scrolling there. This is called mixed hyperlink. क्यों mixed hyperlink है? ये second web page के जो हमें main.html है उसके last section के साथ linking है इसकी. So this is called mixed link. So the coding is here. Bhumika, it is clear?
सर इसकी कोडिंग एक बार आप बता दो फिर से।
यस बेटा, ये एचआर है, नेम ऑफ द फाइल एचटीएमएल फाइल, ठीक है, main.html, देन यूज हैश, देन नेम ऑफ सेक्शन, तो न्यू इज द नेम ऑफ द सेक्शन डिफाइंड इनसाइड द main.html फाइल। तो हमने वहां पे main.html में हमने बॉटम में लिखा हुआ है ए नेम इक्वल टू न्यू। भूमिका क्लियर?
यस सर क्लियर।
सो दिस इज हाइपरलिंक विद इट्स अ मिक्स्ड हाइपरलिंक। सो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड हियर एक्सटर्नल हाइपरलिंक, इंटरनल हाइपरलिंक, मिक्स्ड हाइपरलिंक। नेक्स्ट वन इज we can also provide hyperlinks with any email id. This is not a type of email, type of hyperlinks. So here is I use here br tag to change line. Here I am using a href equal to double quote start. Here, use the keyword mail to. Okay, this is a keyword, mail to. Then use colon sign. Then the email ID. Okay, you will give the email ID of your email ID, because with the help of web page, you will receive the email. So I am giving here both abc@yahoo.co.in. It means this is the email ID. This is the email ID of the owner of web page. Then any message, click here to send an email. Then I close the anchor tag. So here mail to is a keyword. Then you will give colon. Then the email ID. The email ID of the owner to whom you want to send email. I'm going to save this document. Now, in browser, so this is my web page. First one is click here to assess. Last image is a internal link. But click here to send email. I click here. Okay, beta, whenever you are assessing any web page, this is called a link, active link, and active link color is always red. Okay, beta. 1 minute. So I click here. So my your email service provider page will be appear, or otherwise, if I open in any other browser, suppose I am going to open this in Mozilla Firefox. So click here to send email. Okay, again. So my email, the default email ID web page will appear. So if I am using a Gmail, my Gmail web page will appear. And I will have to select the account, and after that I can send the email. Previously it was with the help of a third party software, Outlook Express. Now there are some changes in this, and now hyperlink is provided with the with any website, email website. Previously, it was with the third-party software like Outlook Express, because Outlook Express is not installed in my computer. If it is installed in my computer and I click here to send email, then Outlook Express will appear, and with the help of that software, I can send emails. Okay, students, any doubt in this? Keshav, any doubt? Syllabus of term 2. So in HTML, in term 2, in HTML, we discuss about cascading style sheets and different attributes like color, background color, border style, margin, height, width, outline, font, family, align, load, we have already discussed. Then in the case of your link tag, we have discussed about significance of linking. It is used for providing hyperlinks. Anchor tag, its attribute HIF, mail to, we have already discussed. Then there is another attribute that is called target. The target attribute will decide where you want to open the web page. Okay, here in my in my web page. 1 minute. So my web page is here. I click here to access the last image. Same image is that image is in the same tab. Okay, I can control it. So if I want to open the this web page, the targeted web page in another tab, then I will have to take the target attribute. Okay, so here I'm taking here target element, target equal to in double quotes blank. So I'm saving this. Now I click here to assess last image in the same 1 minute. So here is click here to assess my last image. So a new tab is inserted here. Okay, a new tab aa gayi, usme the element already previous file is remain same or एक जो आपकी targeted image है या targeted web page will appear in new tab. The coding is here. target equal to underscore blank. If I am taking underscore self, so it again it will be appear in same tab. By default it is same tab. I'm saving this. Now if I click here, so my web page, targeted web page will appear in the same tab. This is with the help of which one? Target attribute. So in target attribute, we can also give here frame name, because frame is not in your syllabus. So that's why I am not taking here frame name, because frame is not in your syllabus. So the different values of target attribute of HTML. So blank to open the link document in a new window or tab, self underscore self, open the link document in the same frame as it was clicked in the same tab. Then underscore parent, open the link document in parent frame. This is topic of frame attribute. Then underscore top, open the link document in full body of window. That is again the attribute of the concept of a frame. So if I am giving here the top, it will not give any type of effect here. I am taking here top. So I am refreshing the web page. I click here. So it will appear in the same tab, because here the values top underscore parent are the topic of a frame attribute, a frame tag. The frame tag is not in your syllabus. So here the possible value of a frame attribute is number one. Target attributes, it is number one, blank. In case you want to open the that web page in new tab, self, by default self, if you want to open the web page in same tab, parent and top, these are used in the frame tag. Okay, so these are the possible values of a target attribute of anchor tag. So if you have any doubt, you can raise your hands. So we have discussed here in the case of linking, we have discussed the significance of linking, anchor tag, href, mail to, and target. We have discussed, we completed CSS. Then we also completed the table tag, table, tr, th, td, row span, and row span. Students, there is one tag that is called caption. Caption tag is used to give the caption to your web page. It is always used when after the starting of table tag. Suppose I have to start table tag, then you can give caption. Okay, caption is the context that is appear in the top of your table and in the center of the table. Okay, so after that, give some caption, my table, and then close caption, and then start a tier like this. Now, Monday, next week we will discuss the how we can embed audio and video in HTML. So after that our practical portion will be completed and then we will start the networking topics. Okay, students, time is over. I am now going to close the meeting.